just to say one for me, which is that I was very pleased today to present the final designs for the school street scheme, which is a scheme we're bringing in to close off roads outside the first six schools in the first pilot. We remember problem with one, but actually we're already delivering really. So in terms of the plans that we set up, and we might need a corporate plan and a half if we keep on at this rate until 2020, but we'll see how we get to. So all decisions agreed, is that on the report?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Right, moving on to housing delivery proposals. Councillor Kirby, given that people can't talk because like these are infectious or issues, that's going to politely ask you to take charge. Is that legal? Yeah, fine.
Is it legal? Yeah. Right. I think we've had this before, so and I've published various articles about it, so I'll just give you an overview, and if anyone has any questions, I'll see how to answer them. The headline figures are that we are looking to bid to submit Khan's Building Homes for Londoners, Council Homes for Londoners Fund, with a view to building 750 council houses started on site by 2022. We are also looking at providing a loan for Meridian to be able to deliver 300 new homes as well. So 1,000 plus homes, genuinely affordable for local people. There are a number of other streams to the work that we're looking to do. So decision 1.2, continuing our work on modern methods of construction. Decision 1.3, which is around builds on the work that David and the team have done around specialist housing, because it's not just about the numbers of homes that we deliver, it's also about delivering quality homes to people who need it, be they older people or people with disabilities and other specialist needs. Decision 1.4, which is we're determined to be radical and outward looking in the way that we provide housing. This decision would allow us to look to explore community land trusts, which have been successful in providing affordable housing in other areas. Decision 1.5, built on our commitment around cooperative housing. Decision 1.7, builds on the work that we've already been doing that enables us to partner with housing associations and other housing providers. Decision 1.8 is basically our attempt to intervene in the private rented market, which is failing local people. And it's our view that we can't take a laissez-faire attitude to that, and we need to try and intervene in a market that's failing. 1.9 allows us the officer side capacity to deliver on this agenda. 1.10 is around consultation and enabling us to have an exemplary approach to consultation that gives residents a genuine say in schemes that affect them in the local area. And 1.11 is around maximising social value. If you take the amount of money that we would be spending on providing 1,000 plus genuinely affordable homes, and as well as our repairs work, that's a huge amount of money that we're spending, and that needs to be spent as much as possible in the local economy and providing jobs and opportunities for local people. And 1.11 sets out our commitment to that. And I think that's a very brief overview, Chair. I'm happy to answer any questions.
Thank you very much. Just to add one thing for me, because obviously numbers had planned for Mrs. May's surprise announcement about the HRA cap when she came dancing on as a dancing queen. Imagine on today's news it could be SLS or The Winner Takes It All, but I don't have a couple of songs. But just to say that we are absolutely waiting for the details on that, and I think that is the crucial bit that none of us have. So whilst we will respond